19 related reagents, enzymes, medical equipment, testing kits, PPEs, masks, gloves, medicine and other accessories and cargo requisitioned by state and the governments of the Union Territory. The Lifeline Udaan flights have received excellent support from all the stakeholders, the state governments and the other stakeholders. Private scheduled operators have also operated cargo flights on a commercial basis. Similarly, on the request of various agencies, Air India has operated chartered flights to bring 1,444 tons of critical medical supplies from abroad, that is, into India. They have also, Air India has also carried about 30 tons of critical medical cargo to foreign countries. Now, the point I want to stress under Lifeline Udaan is it represents a very important segment of our activity post the lockdown being declared. Because the lockdown was effective, because it was taken early and in a timely manner, we can today say with a great deal of confidence that we have been able to escape the situation which other countries found themselves in. I mean, for a country of India's size, 1.35 billion people, we are testing what, 100,000 people a day? More than that. And the total number of fatalities is about 3,000 or so. Our recovery rate is doing very well. But you know, when you have a situation like this, what you really need to do is not to look at the total number of cases, but to look at the fatalities. And you have to manage those. Now, the fatalities today, the Indian figure is one of the lowest in the world. It is about 3% or so. And as I, since I'm a member of the group of ministers dealing with this pandemic chaired by my senior colleague, Dr. Harshvardhan, I keep asking the question, Secretary of Civil Aviation is also a member. I say, out of these 3% of fatalities, how many of them are cases where the patients had pre-existing medical conditions or comorbidities, as it's called? And the figure is sometimes termed to be extremely high, 85% or so. So all I'm saying is we have to keep our fingers crossed. But just as it was very important, absolutely essential to have a lockdown early and ensure that the pandemic didn't spread, it is, I think, also equally important at some stage that you have to open up. And I think it's in that spirit that all these decisions are being taken. You could argue, if you were to look at it only from a narrow sectarian point of view, that you should continue to be in a continued phase of lockdown for an extended period of time. Well, I'm one of those, and I think most of you will agree, 56 days or 2 months is a fairly long period of time. And that when you come to balance between, as an Honorable Prime Minister keeps reminding us, between life and livelihood, between Jaan and Jahan, I think the time has come for us to open out. Now, we have been in touch with the state governments at different levels, informally, formally. And I can share with you today that after that we announced yesterday's decision, I think I tweeted it around 5 o'clock or so. Secretary and I were part of a consultative process. When we got to know, we tweeted it. We wanted to have this press conference at the earliest so that those of you who might have questions will get an opportunity. It was also necessary for us to put out SOPs, which have all been uploaded on our ministry's website, I'm told. Although I must confess, many of you were running the SOPs well before we had drafted them or finalized them. But that, I suppose, is a function of a robust democracy, where very often my friends in the fourth estate tell me how I should be running my job. I'm very happy receiving the advice, but I always keep saying, I have, you know, some of you are here, I don't want to embarrass you. They send me message, is this correct? So I said, I can't comment whether this is correct or not correct, because we haven't taken a decision. Now, if it's a very difficult situation. If I say it's not correct, then, you know, it has an implication. If I say it's correct, you know, tomorrow we may come to that conclusion, but we are not ready to announce it. Today we've announced the SOPs. Again, a very comprehensive process which involved our airport operators, Chairman Airports Authority, through him the other major airports, and our air carriers, our airlines. And I must, I know I'm in a, you know, it's a difficult terrain to navigate, but I can tell you all the stakeholders, whether it's the airlines, the airport authority as an organization, airport operator, the security segments of the civil aviation, Rakesh and his team, or, you know, other stakeholders, some of you, some of them don't come in front. Everybody has cooperated, and I think the decision we've taken finally is that starting Monday the 25th, we will recommence domestic civil aviation operations in a calibrated manner. As I said, many of you said, what does calibrated mean and what is the percentage? Some put a figure at 30, some at 35. This is part of the game. But let me try and now put some precision to that. And as I said, the domestic civil aviation operations will be permitted with effect from 25th May to a limited extent of the required and approved capacity of the summer schedule 2020, as I'm going to list out. For operations from metro to metro cities,